Britain is back in business with shops, gyms and hairdressers reopening as lockdown restrictions ease. For the first time in more than 3 months, pubs serve drinkers. And Carrie-Anne Greenbank says the pints were flowing.
4, 3, 2, 1. Ladies and gentlemen, take your seats. Have your first drinks. Please come down.
First pints at midnight in London.
It's official. Ladies and gentlemen, take your seats. We can now get a drink.
Pubgoers braving a freezing spring morning with a dusting of snow for the taste of freedom.
We've got an order.
Robin, we've got an order.
Right across England, beer gardens reopened.
Thank you very much.
Brits issuing a collective sigh of relief as the country emerged from its third and hopefully last national lockdown.
We didn't know how this was going to work out. We didn't even know if anyone was going to come. It's in Huddersfield, it's midnight, it's freezing cold. But look, everyone's come.
Hairdressers now open too.
I'm just so happy to be here, finally.
One salon with a backlog of 3,000 customers. One of the first off to the barber, Boris Johnson, the British Prime Minister, emerging with a slightly more tamed mop.
It's a bit like a fresh start, I guess, you know, sort of a time to sort of cut away the nonsense from last year and get ready for this sort of, hopefully, new and opening of life.
On London's high streets, it was all about the shopping, with queues at major department stores, customers laden with bags, their first in-person buys since December. The owners of Windsor's Duke of Edinburgh pub welcomed back patrons, proposing a national toast, now that they can, to Prince Philip.
I'm going to phone the brewery and see if they fancy brewing an ale in his name as a sort to honour him.
Here in Windsor, shopping strips that were dormant yesterday are slowly coming back to life, but not all venues have reopened. Indoor dining won't be allowed until mid-next month, with the aim of all restrictions easing in June.
But for now, a drink at the pub is sweet enough. In Windsor, Carrie-Anne Greenbank, Nine News.